with the Marriage Act. You'll say, Father, you've had no time left on the Marriage Act. This is the thing I'm most scared of. How can I handle it? It's so short and so simple, you've done it already. To begin with, once you told your child that your daddy and I loved each other so much God gave you to us, that's already the first idea of the Marriage Act. The next step. The daddy puts a seed inside the mommy, the baby goes into the mother's heart. You heard the little fellow say. They don't wonder how or what or where. That's the idea. So daddy's got something to do with it. The third step. Now, it doesn't have to be in this order, but I'm suggesting as they get more and more mature. You know, when God wants something to grow, he has a seed, meat, and egg. And, see, the seed grows from the daddy's body. Remember, I told you, little boy, your little back, your hand, and your leg, that's where the seed grows. The mommy and egg grow all over here and over here. Now, the daddy puts away the seed inside the mommy's body, the seed plays in the baby's mouth. God, here's the thing. You have the seed, meat, and egg, and the baby grows up. You get that idea. And then finally, they hold the man's body. When the child will know the meaning of love, the pure meaning of love, is that we know if we love someone we want, or we're one with them, that means that if we love the child, then we're all with them, and that's what love means. Now many people can be one of them, and say, but when you love one before, they're not only caring for their basis, but they're the basis of all the things.
But married people can be one, not just in spirit.
Listen to me. Don't move when we're in the field of the vibrations. You move, they may see you. It will see you. Stay still.
We'll be right back. wish you could see. Once we come on in, once we come inside my own living, my own free prayer. I wish you could see. My own, 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 my own,
The book of St. Luke. I'm reading from chapter 21. Jesus uttered these words 2,000 years ago. He said, "And there shall be signs in the sun and in the moon and in the stars, and upon the earth distress of nations." I do not want to sound like a preacher of gloom, but things are going to get worse before they get better, because the Bible says they are. And if there is a passage of scripture that describes this present age, this one is. Distress of nations. With perplexity, and the word perplexity means a problem without a solution. Who can solve the problem of Vietnam? Who today can solve the problem of India? Who can solve the problem of the sleeping dragon China that is just now beginning to stir awake with its 800 million population? Who can solve the population explosion? Who can solve the terrible crisis of money that is threatening to engulf the entire world in economic crisis? Who can solve the communistic efforts to engulf the whole world in slavery? Distress of nations with perplexity. It said the sea and the waves roaring. Now this passage means the nations and the peoples of the nations roaring in discontent. The 26th verse says men's hearts failing them for fear, for looking after those things which are coming upon the earth, for the powers of heaven shall be shaken. Now that doesn't mean heart attacks. The heart, when it speaks in the Bible of the heart, it very seldom ever means the physical organ that pumps blood. 99% of the time it's speaking of the spirit of man. And it means here that man will have heart trouble. That's not what it's referring to. It means that men will just lose heart. Their spirits will just flag and say, "What's the use?" As they see these things coming upon the world, they'll lose heart, just don't want to keep on. He said, "And then shall they see the Son of Man coming in a cloud with power and great glory." And this is speaking of the second coming, when he'll set his feet bodily upon the Mount of Olives in Jerusalem, and it'll cleave to the east and the west. And he'll come back personally with his saints with him. I plan to be in that number. When these things begin to pass, begin to come to pass, then look up and lift up your heads, for your redemption calleth nigh. I want to use for a subject tonight divine missiles, atomic bombs, and the second coming of Jesus Christ. I announced last evening another subject for tonight. After praying, Father, I have not felt the love of God to continue in that direction. Second coming of Jesus. Would you bow your heads?
Yeah. Yeah, I want it.